Brothers and sisters, today we are rediscovering our relationship with Allah. We know why Allah has created us. وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ Indeed, I have never created jinn and insan, jinn and human being, jinn and mankind, except to worship me, to believe in me, to worship me, to obey me, to follow me. And to fear Allah, اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ اتَّقُوا رَبَّكُمْ So we believe in Allah. What kind of belief is it? We fear Allah. Do we fear Allah and we are scared and we are in panic? Like when we see something horrible, some kind of like lion or tiger is chasing you, you are in panic, you are scared. Are we scared of Allah like that? No, never. Are we scared of Allah like we are scared of a snake? No. We fear Allah, we obey Him, we follow Him, we respect Him. But same time, we love Him because He is our creator. He is our originator. He sent us to this world. He has given us all this sustenance, this lifespan, beautiful life, education, good health, family, wife, husband, children, house, car, job, everything we enjoy. And we are grateful to Allah for all this favor, and we continue to worship Him alone, nobody else. As He is the only deity, He introduced Himself in the Quran. We must know that. We must renew our faith in Allah. In a hadith, in a prophetic tradition, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, جَدَّدُ إِيمَانَكُمْ You need to renew your iman every time, your faith in Allah. Because iman becomes sometimes very old, feelingless. Dead iman. Like you have your clothes become old, you need to renew, you need to buy a new clothes. So iman need to be renewed every time. That's why you come back to Quran, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described Himself. We know we can't imagine Allah. We can't have our own concept about Allah. It is Allah, the God, who will give us about Him. How is He? He says His attributes, His power, His ability. In many of the Quranic ayat, He has told about Him. He introduced Himself. So we need to renew iman through reading those. And you know very well-known verse of the Quran, Ayat al-Kursi, the verse of the throne where Allah attributed Himself, described Himself. Allahu la ilaha illa huwa al-hayy al-qayyum, this great ayah. The meaning of that ayah, as you know, there is no deity. Allah, there is no deity except Him, the ever-living, the sustainer of all existence. Neither drowsiness overtakes Him nor sleep. To Him belongs whatever is in the heavens and whatever is on the earth. Who is it that can intercede with Him except by His permission? He knows what is presently before them and what will be after them. And they encompass not a thing of His knowledge except of what He wills. His throne extends over the heavens and the earth, and their preservation tires Him not. And He is the Most High, the Most Great. He also introduced Himself in Surah 3, Ayah 27. Say, O Allah, owner of sovereignty, you give sovereignty to whom you will, and you take sovereignty away from whom you will. You honor whom you will, and you humble whom you will. In your hand is all good. Indeed, you are over all things competent. He said also, He caused the night to enter the day, and we call Him, you cause the day to enter the night, and you bring the living out of the dead, and you bring the dead out of the living, and you give provision to whom you will without account. Giver of life, giver of death, giver of all sustenance is Allah. Although we are used as a means, but ultimate giver is Allah, and we are the receiver. Alhamdulillah, خلق السماوات والأرض وجعل الظلمات والنور ثم الذين كفروا بربهم يعدلون. All praise is due to Allah who created the heavens and the earth and made the darkness and the light. Then those who disbelieve equate others with their Lord. He's alone. There is no partner of him. هو الذي خلقكم من طين ثم قضى أجلا وأجل مسمى عنده ثم أنتم تمترون. It is he who created you from clay and then decreed a term and a specified time known to him, a fixed life span. Then still you are in dispute. You are still in dispute who should be your God, who should be worshipping, while he is the giver of life and death and everything. Nobody has right to be worshipped except him. How you dispute about this issue? وَهُوَ اللَّهُ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَفِي الْأَرْضِ يَعْلَمُ سِرَّكُمْ وَجَهْرَكُمْ وَيَعْلَمُ مَا تَكْسِبُونَ. And he is Allah, the only deity in the heavens and the earth. He knows your secret and what you make public, and he knows that which you earn. This way you'll find many of the Quranic verses describing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. His real introduction is introducing himself to us, his real description. We have to believe in that, and we have to enjoy that relationship with Allah. The faith is not only fearing Allah, as you say, we enjoy that because he continuously giving us, he's protecting us, he'll be giving us more goodness in this world, and we're expecting even better in the hereafter. In a hadith of Qudsi, a prophetic tradition, prophet narrated it from Allah, that's why it's called Hadith Qudsi, he said that Allah the exalted and glorious said in this long hadith to us, O my slaves, I have prohibited myself injustice and have made oppression unlawful for you. So do not oppress one another. O my slaves, all of you are liable to error except the one whom I guide on the right path. So seek guidance from me so that I will guide you to the right path. O my slaves, all of you are hungry except the one whom I feed. So ask food from me. So he is a sustainer. I will feed you. O my slaves, all of you are naked except those whom I clothe. So ask clothing of me and I shall clothe you. O my slaves, you commit sins night and day and I forgive all sins. So seek my forgiveness and I shall forgive you. O my slaves, you can neither do me any harm nor can you do me any good. O my slaves, I am the first of you and the last of you, the human of you and jinn of you, to be as pious as the most pious heart of any man of you, what that would not increase in my domain a thing. O my slaves, I am the first of you and the last of you, the human of you and the jinn of you, to be as wicked as the most wicked heart of any man of you, that would not decrease my domain in a thing. O my slaves, or the first of you, and the last of you, the human of you, and the jinn of you, to stand in one place and make a request of me, a long list of everyone, and were I to give everyone what he requested, that would not decrease what I have, any more than a needle decreases the sea if you put into it. O my slaves, it is. But your deeds, in the end, it is your deeds and actions that I reckon for you and then recompense you for. So let him who finds good, i.e. in the hereafter, praise Allah, and let him who finds other than that, blame no one but himself. This is the main purpose of this relationship. As I said, it is not the fear only a Muslim will have about Allah, will enjoy this relationship with you, our God, with Allah, because he is the giver of everything And we live with this faith, we'll die with this faith. Even a death could be something a believer is very happy because he's coming to meet Allah after the death. A great scholar, Sufyan al-Thawri, rahmatullah alayhi, دخل يوما في البحر ليعوم فجاء رجل فأخذ ثيابه فلما خرج من البحر لم ير ثيابه فبينما هو كذلك فإذا باللص قد جاء بها وقد شلت يده اليمنى فقال يا رب قد رددت إلي لي ثيابي فردد عليه يده فرد الله عليه يده. This great scholar went to a river to have his bath, shower, to wash himself. And when he gone inside the river, he left his clothes outside to change. And when he came back, he found his clothes is not anymore there. Somebody came to steal, a thief came and took it away. Of course, he's asking Allah, give me back. And then very quickly, within a short period of time, the thief came back carrying this cloth with his right hand, while his hand is now is paralyzed. Sufyan al-Thawri thanked Allah for giving his cloth back. He said, oh Allah, you're very grateful giving me my cloth back to me. Can I, Allah, urge you to give his hand back to him? See the relationship. He's not taking revenge. He knows Allah is very kind and merciful. Allah, could you give his hand back? And he prayed to Allah, and this thief's hand came back functioning. This is the relationship. In all cases, you enjoy it. This is called halawat al-iman, sweetness of iman. Even though you are going through serious trouble, it's not only pain of the disaster, it is same time, you enjoy the relationship with Allah. Ali ibn Sahl al-Asbahani, rahmatullah Ali, great scholar. He used to say to his friends, I hope I'll be not dying like many other people die. I'll be just called by Allah, get ready, and I'll be ready, and he'll take me. This was his hope. One day he was, he said to the friends, أَتَظُنُّونَ أَنِّي أَمُوتُ كَمَا يَمُوتُ النَّاسِ إِنَّمَا أُدْعَى يُقَالُ يَا عَلِي فَأَجِيبُ فذات يوم وهو يسير بين نفر من إخوانه وأصحابه وقف فجأة وصاح لبيك ثم مال على أكتاف صحبه وفاضت روحه. While he was walking one day with his friends, then suddenly he screamed, لبيك, I'm ready, my Lord. And suddenly he was falling down onto the shoulder of his friends. And within a short period of time, he has died. The way he wanted to meet Allah, he wanted. He met. Abdul Ala ibn Hamad said, Bishr ibn Mansur is a great scholar and pious person of Allah. He was in struggling with his death in last breath, going to die. وَإِذَا هُوَ مِنَ السُّرُورِ فِي عَمْرٍ عَظِيمٍ. And he is very happy. While it is Sakaratul Maut, as you know, even Prophet ﷺ said, La ilaha illallah, inna lil maut sakarat. There is pain of the death, but yet Prophet ﷺ said, Allahumma ar-rafiqul a'la, wa Allah, my highest Lord, my highest friend. He is eager to meet him with that pain. He enjoyed that relationship, and he died. Same way this man, Bishr ibn Mansur, was very happy before, in his death time. They said, why you are happy? As if you are now in his last breath. He said, Subhanallah, أخرج من بين الظالمين والحاسدين والمغتابين والباغين وأقدم على أرحم الراحمين. Why I'll be not happy? This world is full of the unjust people, the oppressors, the jealous people, and those who backbite, and those who transgress. I'm leaving all this. I'm going to meet my Allah, the most kind and most merciful. Why I'll be not happy, not eager to meet him? Al-Dhunnun al-Misri, rahmatullah alayhi. He nicely explained this sweetness of faith, of iman. He said, إِذَا اسْتَحْكَمَتْ مَعَانِ الْمَحَبَّةِ فِي قَلْبِ الْمُؤْمِنِ سَكَنَ بَعْدَهَا الشَّوْقِ فإذا اشتاق أداه الشوق إلى الأنس بالله، فإذا أنس بالله اطمأن إلى الله، فإذا اطمأن كان ليله في نعيم ونهاره في نعيم وسره في نعيم وعلانيته في نعيم. He said, when love of Allah, which is part of our faith, is engraved in heart of a believer, then he finds he's very eager to meet Allah. When this eagerness is there, and then they will enjoy this relationship. And will be nothing will be much more enjoyable than this relationship with Allah. When this relationship is there with them, they'll get peace and rest and tranquility. And when this peace and rest with them, their day and night, goodness and badness, anything happen to them, they're always in favor of Allah, in ni'mah of Allah, they enjoy this relationship. Nothing can take away from them, even though there is bitter kind of test in the life, still they enjoy the sweetness of the faith, sweetness of iman. Allahumma inna nas'aluka ladhata an-nadhar ila wajhika wa shawqa ila liqa'ika fi ghayri dharra'a mudhirra wa la fitnati mudilla. Allahumma zayyinna bi zinati al-iman واجعلنا هداة مهتدين. بارك الله لي ولكم في القرآن العظيم ونفعني وإياكم بما فيه من الآيات والذكر الحكيم. وأقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين من كل ذنب، فاستغفروا واتوبوا إليه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم.